Hi children, this is Venkatramana. Now today's class, 10th class physical science, that is numericals based on balanced chemical equations. Numericals based on balanced chemical equations. Now already we discussed regarding interpreting a balanced chemical equation. What information a chemical equation gives us? It gives us regarding information of reactants and products. It gives regarding physical states of reactants and products. It also gives information regarding ratio of reactants and products reacting. And also it tells about relative masses of reactants and products. Relative mass of reactants and product. So simply we can tell that it gives information about relative masses of reactants and products. So from the equation, we will get mass to mass relation, mass to volume relation, mass to volume relation, and mass to volume and volume to number of molecules relation. Now, first of all, let us do a numerical based on mass to mass relation. Mass to mass relation. Now, first example problem. Let us take one problem. What are calculate the amount of aluminium, calculate the amount of aluminium required to get 1120 kg of iron when iron oxide is reacting with aluminium. When iron oxide reacts with aluminium. Aluminium that we have to calculate. So here, why it is known as mass to mass relation? Because here they give the mass of iron, they are asking to find the mass of aluminium. That means they give the mass of one product and they are asking to find the mass of reactant. That's why it will come under mass to mass relation. Mass to mass relation. Now how to do? First step is we have to write the chemical equation. We have to write the chemical equation. Second step is we have to balance the chemical equation. We have to balance the chemical equation. Third step, we have to find out what to what relation we have to find. That means whose mass they gave and what mass we have to find out. Then we have to calculate. In that way, we have the steps involved in the chemical calculations. Nothing but numericals on chemical calculations. So, first of all, let us try to write the equation. Now, what is the equation here? Aluminium is reacting with iron oxide. This is the iron oxide. Iron oxide is reacting with aluminium. These two are reactants. Then what you will get? You will get iron as a product. Iron as a product and one of the product and the other one is remainder. So let us try to write the equation. Iron oxide Fe2O3 plus aluminium gives rise to, as aluminium is what you call more reactive than the iron, high reactive than the iron, it will displace iron. That's why you will get aluminium oxide plus iron. Now we wrote the equation. So iron oxide plus aluminium, they gave in the problem. We are getting iron. As a result, iron displacement means what we get now? Aluminium oxide. Now we have to balance the equation. Iron 2, iron 1. So let us balance the equation. Fe2O3 plus aluminium gives rise to aluminium oxide plus 2 iron. Now iron, iron 2, iron 2. Oxygen 3, oxygen 3. But aluminum 1, here aluminum 2. So let's write 2. Now balanced equation. After balanced equation, we have to find out whose mass they give and what whose mass we have to find out. They give the mass of iron, we have to find out the aluminum mass. So from the equation, let us find the information. What information? Iron oxide weight doesn't require, because you want relation from iron oxide, aluminum to iron. Aluminum to iron we want. So let us write that part. So 2 aluminum, 2 into, what is the atomic weight of aluminum? Atomic number of aluminum is 13. So its atomic weight is 27. So 2 into 27 grams of aluminum, aluminum use. Now 2 into iron, iron weight is 56. So 56 in grams of iron, directly we are writing iron. Now we are not mentioning about iron oxide, aluminum oxide, because in problem doesn't require. Actually 2 into 27 grams of aluminum should react with so and so grams of iron oxide to give so and so grams of aluminum oxide and to give to so and so grams of iron. That is step we required to write. But here doesn't require of aluminum oxide and iron oxide. That's why we are not mentioning their atom, their molecular masses. Now 2 into 27 means 54. So 54 grams of 54 grams of aluminum use 112 grams of iron. 112 grams of iron. But in numerical, how many grams of aluminum we have to get, they're asking? 1120 kg of iron we are required, they're asking. And we have to find out whose mass, iron or aluminum, aluminum mass we have to find. Therefore, so we let us assume that let x grams of aluminum use how much? 1120 into 1000. Why I am writing 1 kilo means 1000. So 1000 grams of iron. 1000 grams of iron. Then what do you get? Therefore, x is equals to 1120 into 54 by 112. 1120 into 1000 by 54 into how much? 1120 into 1000 by 54 into 112. Now these two are cross multiplication. So you have to write 54, you have to write in by 112. 1120 into 1000 into 54 by 112. Now 112 ones are, 112 tens are. Now 10 into 54, 540. Therefore, x is equal to what you are getting? 540 grams. 1000 means kg. So, how many grams of aluminum can able to give? 1120 kg of iron. Therefore, you can tell that 540 grams of iron, aluminum. Therefore, 540 kg of aluminum reacts with whom it is reacting? Iron oxide to give 1120 kg of iron. That way you can able to write. So note down. Now it will come under mass to mass relation. How it will come under mass to mass relation? Because they gave the mass of iron and they are asking to find the mass of aluminium. That's why it will come under mass to mass relation. Mass to mass relation. Now we have to go for mass to volume relation. Mass to mass. There is relation between molar mass to molar volume. There is relation between molar mass to molar volume. What is the relation between molar mass to molar volume? 1 mole of any gas, 1 mole of any gas occupies 22.4 liters of volume. How much? 22.4 liters of volume. Then how to get relation between mass to moles? We know that one molecular weight of any molecule. One molecular weight of any molecule is equals to 1 mole. Each mass is equals to 1 mole. That means, so if you know the mass, we can able to find its moles. Then if you know the moles, we can able to write its molar mass, molar volume. We can able to write molar volume. So then let's go for another numerical based on mass to volume relation. Mass to volume relation. That means they will give mass. We have to find volume because in that reaction gases are involved. If the gases are involved, generally gases we will express in terms of volume, but not in terms of mass. Not in terms of mass. That's why what we call there should be a relation between mass to volume. What is the mass to volume? One molecule mass is equals to 1 molar. 1 mole. It will occupy how much space? 22.4 liters of volume. 22.4 liters of volume. Now, let us go for another numerical which will give idea regarding mass to volume. Mass to volume. Now, calculate next example 2. We can tell what is example 2. Calculate the volume. Calculate the first mass we'll find. Calculate the mass, volume and also number of molecules of hydrogen liberated. Number of molecules of hydrogen liberated when 230 grams of sodium, when 230 grams of sodium reacts with excess of water. 230 grams of sodium reacts with excess of water. Excess of water. This is the numerical. So what they gave? They gave the mass of sodium and they are asking to find mass of hydrogen. And also they are asking to find volume of hydrogen liberated. And also they are asking to find number of molecules of hydrogen liberated. So first let us write the chemical equation. Then we will go for balance in the chemical equation. After balance in the chemical equation, we have to get the relation between given and required to find. Then simplification. So, first of all, what they give here? What they give is 230 grams of sodium. It is reacting with water. These two are reactants. And in that process, we will get hydrogen. Means hydrogen is liberated. So, let us write that chemical equation. So, what here? Sodium reacting with water. Then, it gives rise to sodium hydroxide plus hydrogen gas will be liberated. sodium being a metal, when metal dissolved in water, it gives rise to bases. It gives rise to bases. Sodium hydroxide plus hydrogen. Now let us go for balance in the equation. Sodium 1, sodium 1. Hydrogen 2, hydrogen 2. Oxygen, hydrogen 3 here. So let us make 2 here. So we will make 2 sodium. Sodium plus water gives rise to 2 sodium hydroxide plus hydrogen. As a result, now hydrogen 2 to 4. So we are making 2 here. But 2 sodiums we have. 2 sodiums also are there. So 2 sodium. 2 2s are 4 hydrogens, 2 hydrogens plus 2 hydrogens, 4 hydrogens, 2 oxygens, 2 oxygens. Now balance. So let us find the atomic weights from the equation. Now first of all, we want relation between sodium to hydrogen. Sodium to hydrogen, we want relation. That means they give sodium and they are asking to find hydrogen weight, mass they are asking to find. And also its volume they are asking to find, and also what you call, we have to find out how many number of molecules of hydrogen liberated. So 2 into sodium, 2 sodium means sodium number is how much? 13. Sodium number is 11, so its atomic weight mass is 23. So 2 into 23 grams of sodium gives rise to how many? Your hydrogen weight is 1. So 1 into 2 grams of hydrogen liberated. Now actually we have to write the masses of water and also sodium hydroxide. But here according to given problem, they doesn't require. Directly we are finding the relation between given and required to find. Given and required to find. So 2 into 23 means 46 grams of sodium gives how many? 2 grams of hydrogen. But according to problem, how many grams of sodium they gave? 230 grams of sodium. We are assuming that it gives x grams of hydrogen. Therefore, then x is equal to what will get? X is equal to 230 into 2 by 46. 230 into 2 by 46. 2 ones, 223s. 23 ones, 23 tens. That means how many grams of hydrogen we are getting now? X is equals to 10 grams. X is equals to 10 grams. That means here how many grams of hydrogen liberated? 10 grams of hydrogen liberated. That we got, mass we got now. That mass we have to convert into volume. How? First we have to convert into number of moles. After finding number of moles, there is a relation between molar mass to molar volume. 1 mole of any gas at STP, at standard temperature and pressure, at NTP, at normal temperature and pressure. At normal temperature means 0 degrees Celsius temperature or 273 degrees Kelvin. And pressure means 76 centimeters of mercury level or 76 mm of mercury level. So, let us find the relation there. How to find relation now? See, therefore, how many grams of hydrogen liberated here? How many grams of hydrogen liberated? Therefore, 10 grams of H2 liberated. H2 liberated. When 230 grams of sodium reacts with excess of water. When 230 grams of sodium reacts with excess of water. That we got it. So one excess of water. Mass we got. Now we have to convert them into volume. How to convert? Number of moles formula. Number of moles is equals to Given weight by gram molecular weight. whose moles you have to find out here? Number of moles of hydrogen we have to find. That is equals to what is the given weight we got here? 10 grams. How many grams? 10 grams we got. Then gram molecular weight of hydrogen is 2 grams. Hydrogen weight is 2 grams. As a result, you can tell that gram cancel, 2 ones, 2 fives. 2 ones, 2 fives. Then what will you get? 5 moles. 5 moles. Now we have the relation between molar mass to molar volume. What relation? 1 mole of any gas, 1 mole of H2 gas occupies how much space? 22.4 liters at STP. At STP. But how many moles of hydrogen we got? Therefore, 5 moles of hydrogen occupies. How many moles? How many liters? 5 into 22.4 liters multiplied. 5 fours are 22. 5 twos are 10 plus 2, 12. 5 twos are 10. 112 liters of volume. 112 liters of volume. So, just 10 grams of hydrogen at STP. The 10 grams of hydrogen at STP occupying how much space? 112 liters of volume. How much space? 112 liters of volume. Next, we have to find the number of molecules. There is a relation between molar mass to number of molecules. There is a relation between molar mass to Avogadro number. This is a relation here we have. This relation is what we call important. How much? 22.4 liters. So, then we have to find relation between molar mass to Avogadro number. 1 mole of any gas contains 6.023 into 10 power 23 number of molecules of that gas. So with that we can able to find. So please note down next last step we can able to do in half this one. Now, let us find out relation between molar mass to Avogadro number relation. Molar mass to Avogadro number relation. So let me wrap the question. Then here I can able to do that problem. As a result, you can able to copy totally. So, what the relation we have for molar mass to Avogadro number relation? We have relation is 1 mole of any gas at STP. 1 mole of any gas at STP. Now, 1 mole of any gas, 1 mole of H2 gas contains, H2 gas contains how many Avogadro number? What is the Avogadro number? 6.023 into 10 power 23. How to remember this number? 2, 3 are 6. 23 is the power. 23 number of molecules of H2 molecules. Number of molecules of hydrogen. Number of molecules of hydrogen. But here, how many moles we have? 5 moles. So this is the relation between molar mass to Avogadro number. Avogadro number. How many moles you got? Therefore, 5 moles of hydrogen contains, hydrogen contains 5 into 6.023 into 10 power 23. That is equals to 5 threes are 15, 10 power 23 as it is, you'll write. 5 threes are 15, 1. 5 twos are 10 plus 11, 1. 5 6, 30. 30.115 into 10 power 23, number of hydrogen molecules. Number of hydrogen molecules. In that way, we got the relation. So, in this way, we did a problem based on mass to mass relation, mass to volume relation, and also mass to volume and volume to number of molecules relation. Thank you.